students, today I am going to start your third chapter, that is trigonometric functions. You all have studied trigonometry in class 10th also. So we will discuss some parts, means sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, cosec theta. These are six trigonometric ratios. In a right angle triangle, FG is a base, EG is hypotenuse and EF is perpendicular. So according to that, sine theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse. Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. Tan theta is perpendicular by base. Cot theta is base by perpendicular. Sec theta is hypotenuse by base. And cosec theta is hypotenuse by perpendicular. We can write tan theta as sine theta by cos theta also. We can write cot theta as 1 by tan theta or cos theta by sine theta also. You all have studied in class 10th. Now we can write sec theta as 1 by cos theta also. We can write cosec theta as 1 by sine theta also. Similarly, we can write sine theta as 1 by cosec theta also. And cos theta we can write as 1 by sec theta also. You'll have studied it in class 10th. Now in class 10th, we have studied sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. Cosec square theta minus cot square theta equals to 1. Sec square theta minus tan square theta equals to 1. These three formula we have discussed in class 10th. And relation between complementary angles also we have discussed in class 10th. That is sine of 90 minus theta is cos theta. Cos of 90 minus theta is sine theta. Tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. Cot of 90 minus theta is tan theta. Sec of 90 minus theta is cosec theta. And cosec of 90 minus theta is sec theta. And we are knowing trigonometric functions of particular angles also. Means when sine 0 degree we have to take. We know that sine 0 is 0. Then sine 30 degree is 1 by 2. Sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. Sine 90 degree is 1. Then cos 0 degree, that is 1. Cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2. Cos 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. And cos 90 degree is 0. Then tan of 0 degree is 0. Tan of 30 degree, that is 1 by root 3. Tan of 45 degree is 1. Tan of 60 degree is root 3. And tan of 90 degree is infinity or not defined. Then cosec 0 degree, cosec is, cosec we can write as 1 by sine theta. So according to that, here sine 0 degree is 0, so cosec 0 degree is infinity. Then cosec 30 degree will be 2. Then cosec 45 degree is root 2. Then cosec 60 degree is 2 by root 3 and cosec 90 degree is 1. Then sec theta, we know that this is 1 by cosec, 1 by cos theta. So according to that, it sec of 0 degree will be 1. Then sec of 30 degree will be 2 by root 3. Then sec of 45 degree root 2. Then sec of 60 degree will be 2. And sec of 90 degree will be again not defined. 1 by 0 it is. Not defined or infinity. Then cot theta. Cot theta we can write as 1 by tan theta. So cot of 0 degree will be not defined, means infinity. Then cot of 30 degree will be root 3. Then cot of 45 degree will be 1. then cot of 60 degree will be 1 by root 3 and cot of 90 degree will be here 0. We have to know that when we are taking 1 by 0, that is called not defined or infinity. When we are taking 1 by infinity, so that will be 0. When we are taking 0 divisible by any number, so that is again 0. So according to that, these are the trigonometric function angles, values. And I think you are all are knowing, you all have studied in class 10th. Now we will proceed to class 11th portion. This chapter, trigonometric functions, is very important. So we will start with the portion, with the first part of this trigonometric function, that is angle measurement. Angle measurement means how to measure angles. So we will discuss here. First of all, I'm going to draw two types of angles. Here I have drawn an angle. Yeah, angle is AOB. Another angle I have drawn, that is AOC. You can see directions are different here. In the first angle, you can see I have taken direction in anti-clockwise direction. So whenever we take in anti-clockwise direction angle, so all angles will be in positive form, means positive angles will be there. When positive angles? When in anti-clockwise direction. And here another angle I have written, that is in clockwise direction. And whenever we take clockwise direction, the angles will be negative, okay, minus in clockwise. In clockwise direction. Means if I'm taking here, this angle I'm considering as theta, so it will be here. If I'm taking theta equals to 30 degree, this one. So this one will be here in clockwise direction, it will be minus 30 degree. Okay, so this is the way to write angles in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. We write angles with the reference of 0 degree. If it is anti-clockwise, so it is positive, and if it is clockwise, then it is negative. Now we'll discuss unit of angle measurement. There are two units of angle measurement. First is called degree measurement and second is called radian measurement. So one by one we will discuss it. Degree measurement and radian measurement. So I'm going to start degree measurement. I'm taking here a straight line where 2 points here in the straight line, point O and point A. This point O is fixed point I'm taking here. And this point A is free to move. Means we can move this point A according to this fixed point O. So we rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Means this direction when we are rotating this point A. So we are getting a circle, a complete revolution. So here we are getting a complete revolution. Now I'm going to split this total circle into 360 parts like that. If I'm splitting it, small parts I'm taking here, 360 parts. Like that, I'm going to split this whole revolution or one complete revolution. So like this, I'm going to divide it into 360 parts. 360 parts. Then we can write one part, means this one. This is called 1 degree. So we can write 1 degree equals to rotation of 1/360th of a complete revolution. So this is definition of 1 degree. because we are splitting this whole circle into 360 parts, and then one part when we are taking 1 degree, that is, and we can write it as 1 degree equals to rotation of 1/360 of a complete revolution. So according to this, we can write here 1 complete revolution equals to 360 degree. Means this whole, this is 360 degree, and one part means this is 1 degree. Again, this is 1 degree. Equal parts we are taking. This is 1 degree, 1 degree, like that. 360 parts we are taking here. I'm not showing all the parts. It is not possible for me to show. So 1 complete revolution equals to 360 degree means this whole angle in anti-clockwise direction, 360 degree, and one part when we are taking, that is 1 degree. So this is definition of a degree. 1 degree is rotation of 1/360 of a complete revolution. Now we can split 1 degree into 60 parts. Means this 1 degree part, this one, 1 degree again I'm splitting into 60 parts. So we can write here 1 degree equals to 60 minutes. That is called minutes. And again we can split minutes into 60 parts. So that is called seconds. So we can write here 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. We can denote it as minute, we can denote as like that, 1 dash, and then seconds we can denote as 2 dash. So here we have discussed, when we are splitting the whole circle into 360 parts, then we are getting one part as 1 degree, means 1 degree as 1/360 part of a complete revolution, and 1 degree we are getting here 60 minutes, and 1 minute we are getting here 60 seconds. So these are very important things, you have to remember it. Now we'll discuss second unit of angle measurement, that is radian measure. So here I have drawn a circle where I have taken unit radius, means radius is one unit I have taken here radius, and I'm taking here this arc length as 1 unit. Unit means we can measure, if you are measuring in centimeter, so both we will measure in centimeter. If you are measuring in meter, then both will measure in meter. So 1 unit we are taking, I'm taking here. So 1 unit radius I'm taking, R I'm taking here 1 unit. And similarly, this arc length also, you all are knowing length of the arc. Length of arc, that is 1 unit. So according to that, here one angle we are getting in anti-clockwise direction. So this angle will be 1 radian. This is called 1 radian angle. So 1 radian means angle subtended by an arc of unit length. at the center of a unit circle. This is a unit circle because we have taken radius 1 unit. So an angle which is subtended by unit, by an arc of unit length. So that type of angle is called 1 radian. So definition of 1 radian is angle subtended by an arc of unit length at the center of a unit circle. Unit circle means when radius is 1 unit is called 1 radian, and we can write it as 1 radian equals to like that. Small c is there. Degree, we know that how to represent. We know that 1 degree, we represent it as like that, 1 degree, and 1 radian, 1 and then small c. So this is the way to represent. Now when we are taking in anti-clockwise direction like that, so it will be 1 radian positive. But when we are taking in clockwise direction, so it will be minus 1 radian. Okay, so 1 unit length of the arc equals to 1 radian. We have discussed 2 unit length of the arc. If unit length means when we are taking arc length equals to 2 unit. We have taken here 1 unit arc length then this is 1 radian. When we are taking 2 units arc length means this one, this part A to B arc length, this part is 2 units, so it will be 2 radian, like that it will increase. So total circumference will be a length, means length of the arc of a complete revolution. Here we will find out length of arc of a complete revolution. Means total circle angle in terms of radian we are going to find here. So this is equals to what? Circumference. Circumference of the circle. So we know that circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. And here we have taken r as 1 unit. So we can write it as 2 pi into 1. So we have here 2 pi units. So we can write here length of arc of a complete revolution equals to 2 pi units, means 2 pi radian.
So in a circle, when we are taking radius r unit and arc length is l unit, at that condition angle measurement will be theta radian, and we can write it as here one relationship we can write in between theta radian, arc length and radius of the circle. So that relation is theta radian equals to l by r, means arc length divisible by radius, where l and r should be in same unit, be in same unit. So here we are taking radius as r unit and arc length as l. So this is very important relationship between theta radian, arc length and radius of the circle. Means example I am taking here, if I am taking radius equals to 3 centimeter, arc length I am taking here, that is 4 centimeter. So theta radian will be here l by r, means it will be here 4 by 3 radian. We can use this relationship only in radian form. So here we will discuss relation between real number and radian. Means the radian measures and real numbers can be considered as one and the same. every radian measure is a real number, and every real number can be considered as radian measure of some angle. So for this, I have drawn here one diagram. Here I have taken one circular ring of unit radius and one string I have taken x x dash. So what I will do, I will wrap this string into this circular ring. So when I'm wrapping, so this point one will be coming here. So it will be arc length. This part will be one unit. L will be one unit. Similarly, in the process of wrapping, this two point will be coming here. Means here it will touch. So according to that, your radian measure will be 2 radian. Here for the previous one, radian measure will be 1 radian. So you can see, here we are representing radian measure in terms of real numbers. Similarly, if I'm taking this point minus 1 and I'm wrapping this string to this circular ring, so this minus 1 is coming here. So this minus 1 is coming here. So your angle will be here. So from this point minus 1, here this angle will be minus 1 radian. And from the point minus 2, this angle will be minus 2 radian. Means in clockwise direction these are. So we can write here, according to this example, we can show your conclusion that every radian measure is a real number, and every real number can be considered as real radian measure of some angle. Means both are equal. So we can write here, real number n is giving us n radian. And real number and radian will be considered same in terms of magnitude. So both are similar. Now we'll discuss relation between degrees and radians. We have seen that 360 degree equals to 2 pi radian. If you are dividing both sides by 2, so we are getting here 360 by 2 degree equals to 2 pi by 2 radian. So it will be a 180 degree equals to pi radian. Similarly, we can find out some rest, some other values. Means if you are dividing both sides by 2, 180 by 2, and here also by 2. So here left hand side we are getting 90 degree, right hand side pi by 2 radian. 90 degree, this is pi by 2 radian. Then next, when we are dividing this part by 4, dividing both sides by 4. So we are getting here 45 degree equals to pi by 4 radian. This is the fourth part. Similarly, if we have 180 degree equals to pi radian, then we are dividing both sides by 6. If we are dividing both sides by 6, so this is here 180 by 6, and here right hand side it will be pi by 6 radian. So it is here 30 degree equals to pi by 6 radian. Then 180 degree equals to pi radian. Now dividing both sides by 3. So 180 degree by 3 equals to pi by 3 radian. So it is here 60 degree equals to pi by 3 radian. So these are the relations in between degree and radian. One more value we'll discuss, that is if we are taking 270 degree, we can write in radian form, it will be 3 pi by 2 radian. Now in quadrant form, we will show here degrees and radian measures. So here we know that there are four parts, so four quadrants: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. We know that this is 0 degree. In terms of degree, if we are representing, this is 0 degree. This is 90 degree. This part is 90 degree in anticlockwise direction. Now, this is 180 degree. 180 degree. Now, this is 270 degree. Anticlockwise direction. And again, in place of the 0 degree, we write 360 degree. So, these are angles in anticlockwise direction. Now, in clockwise direction, we will discuss. So, in clockwise direction, this is again 0 degree. Now, this part, this is minus 90 degree. Now, this part is minus 180 degree, minus 180 degree. And then this is minus 270 degree. And then finally, this is in place in 0 degree, we use as minus 360 degree in clockwise direction. This is clockwise direction. Negative angle. This is anti-clockwise direction. Positive angle. Now in radian form, we will show it. So this is 0 degree. Now this is pi by 2. This angle is pi by 2. Now this is pi. Then next, this is 3 pi by 2. And then again here, this is 2 pi radian. In anti-clockwise direction. And then clockwise direction, negative radian angles, radian measurement. So here it is 0 degree, 0 radian, and then after that, here it will be minus pi by 2 radian, then it is minus pi radian, this angle is, and then next is minus 3 pi by 2 radian, and then here it is minus 2 pi radian. I hope it is clear for you all how to represent degrees and radians in the quadrant. Now we'll convert degree to radian values and radian to degree values. So first of all, I'm taking the example degree to radian. We have to convert. So the question I'm taking here, if degree is given here, we have to convert 45 degree into radian. This is the question. Convert 45 degree into radian. So we will start with the relation 180 degree equals to pi radian. Now, by unitary method, we can use 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radian. Then we have to find out here 45 degree into radian. So 45 degree equals to pi by 180 into 45. Radian. So finally, we will calculate it. So after calculating, we are getting here pi by 4 radian. Now one question we'll discuss. We will convert radian to degree. So here question is convert pi by 3 radian to degree. So we write pi radian equals to 180 degree. Then 1 radian equals to 180 by pi degree. And then pi by 3 radian we have to find out. So pi by 3 radian equals to 180 by pi into pi by 3 degree. So finally here we are getting 60 degree. So pi by 3 radian equals to 60 degree. So this is the way to convert. Now we'll discuss one question. Convert 40 degree 20 minutes into radian measure. We have discussed earlier that 1 degree equals to 60 minutes and 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. So here question is there in degree and minute also 40 degree 20 minutes. We have to convert into radian measure. So we will start 180 degree equals to pi radian. So 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radian. And here you can see 40 degree 20 minutes. So we have to convert whole into degree. So I'm going to convert here 40 degree 20 minutes. So we can write it as 40 degree plus 20 minutes. And we know that 60 minutes equals to 1 degree. Then 20 minutes equals to 1 by 60 degree. And 1 minute equals to 1 by 60 degree. Then 20 minutes equals to 1 by 60 into 20 degree. So here we are getting 1 by 3 degree. 20 minutes into degree we have converted. So here we will write 40 degree plus 1 by 3 degree. Now we'll add it. So 40 plus 1 by 3 degree. So finally here we are getting 121 by 3 degree. So 40 degree 20 minutes we have converted into total degree. After that we will use this equation 1. So 121 by 3 degree equals to using 1. So we will write it as pi by 180 into 121 by 3. So it will be in radian. We have used here 180 degree equals to pi radian, 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radian, then 121 by 3 degree equals to pi by 180 into 121 by 3 radian. Now we'll calculate it. So after calculating, we are getting 121 pi by 540 radian. So this is our answer. I hope it is clear for you all. Now we will solve one more question, that is convert 6 radian into degree measure. So we know that pi radian equals to 180 degree. Then 1 radian equals to 180 by pi degree. Then 6 radian equals to 180 by pi into 6 degree. But whenever we convert radian to degree, we have to convert totally, means pi value also we have to apply. We can't leave in fraction form when we are converting into degree. But when we are converting degree to radian, we can keep in fraction form, that we have discussed in the previous question. So here we have to solve it totally. We know that pi is 22 by 7 or 3.14. Okay. Here in this chapter, we have discussed that pi radian equals to 180 degree. Pi value is 22 by 7 or 3.14 numeric value. numeral value is this one, but this is conversion, degree and radian conversion. So pi degree equals to 180 degree. This is not the value. Okay. So value of pi is 22 by 7 or 3.14. So we'll apply here. So 6 radian equals to 180 by 22 by 7 into 6 degree. Now we'll solve it. So we are getting here 1080 by 22 into 7.
So here we have 3780 by 11 degree. I've told that we can't keep in fraction form. So we have to solve it. For solving it, I'm going to divide 3780 divisible by 11. So we will show this part in the rough. Now after dividing, here we are getting 33, then here it is 48. Now 4, now we are getting 40, and then finally 3 again. So here we are getting 7. So we can write it as 3780 by 11. We can write as 343 whole 7 by 11. So we can write here. So 6 radian equals to 3780 by 11 degree, and we can write it as 343 whole 7 by 11 degree. Means we can write it as 343 degree plus 7 by 11 degree. Now again we are getting in fraction form. I have told that we can't leave in fraction form. So again we have to divide. Now we'll convert this fraction part into minutes, degree into minutes. So we know that 1 degree equals to 60 minutes. So 7 by 11 degree equals to 7 by 11 into 60 minutes. So we'll calculate it. This is 420 by 11 minutes. Now again we are getting in fraction part. So we'll divide it. So 420 divisible by 11. So here we are getting 420 by 11. We can write as 38 holes 2 by 11. So this is hole in minutes. So we can write here 343 degree plus 38 holes 2 by 11 minute. Again, we are getting in fraction. Again, we have to convert this fraction into seconds. So we can write it as 38 minute plus 2 by 11 minute. For reducing this fraction part, we are converting into units, means degree we have converted into minute, then minute we are converting into seconds. So 2 by 11 minute we are converting into seconds. So 1 minute equals to 60 seconds, then 2 by 11 minutes equals to 60 into 2 by 11 seconds. So it will be a 120 by 11 seconds. Now again we are getting in fraction part. So we will divide here 120 divisible by 11. So here we are getting 340 degree plus 38 minute plus 2 by 11 we have converted into 10.9 seconds. 10.9 seconds. So it is here 10.9 seconds. So round off, we can write it as 340 degree, then 38 minute and 11 seconds approx. So this is the way to convert radian value into degree. If we are getting values in fractions, then continuously we have to convert into minutes and then seconds. So this is our final answer. One question we'll discuss: find the length of an arc of a circle of radius 5 centimeters, subtending a central angle measuring 15 degree. Here central angle is given, means angle AOB is in degree, but this angle is subtended by an arc. So it will be in the radian measure. We have to convert 15 degree into radian measure first. And then we have to find out here length of an arc, means this L value we have to find out here. So this is the question. So I'm going to convert this 15 degree into radian. So we can write it as 15 degree in equals to 15 into pi by 180 radian. So finally we'll have here pi by 12 radian. This is 15 degree. Now we have to find out here L value. We have theta, pi by 12 radian. We have radius, that is 5 centimeters, but we don't know arc length. So we have a relation in between theta r and L, that is theta radian equals to L by r. So we are using this relation here. So we'll apply. This is pi by 12 radian L by 5. So finally L value will find out. So this is here 5 pi by 12 centimeter. So this is our final answer. Now one more question: if the arcs of same length in two circles subtend angles of 60 degree and 75 degree at their centers, find the ratio of their radii. So here two radii are given, r1 and r2, be the radii of the given circles, and their arcs of same length L subtend angles of 60 degree and 75 degree at their centers. So first of all, we have to convert degree into radian, because we know that we can use this relation theta radian equals to L by R when we have angle in radian form. So I'm going to convert 60 degree into radian. So this is 60 into pi by 180 radian. And this is pi by 3 radian. And 75 degree, it is 75 into pi by 180 radian. And this is here 5 pi by 12 radian. So we have converted. Now we will apply here theta radian equals to L by R1. R1 and R2 we have considered. So according to that, we can write here first, let R1 and R2 be the radii of the given circles. So we can write here theta radian equals to L by R1. So first one, that is pi by 3 equals to L by R1, and theta radian equals to, this is first one theta 1 radian we can take, this is theta 2. So L by R2, so this is here 5 pi by 12 radian equals to L by R2. Now we have to find here ratio of the radii. So we can keep it as equation 1 and this is equation 2. Now from equation 1 we can find out L value. So we can write here R1 pi by 3 equals to L. And here equation 2 also will find out L value. So this is 5 pi R2 by 12. So both L, we know that arc length is similar, L. So according to that, we can equate 1 and 2. 1 equals to 2, so it will be here R1 pi by 3 and this is 5 pi R2 by 12. So R1 by R2 will find out. So it will be here 5 pi by 12 into 3 by pi. So ratio is 5 is to 4.